and welcome to Moisture Matters, the show where we take your everyday and not so everyday objects and test them to see which has more moisture. Today we're testing nylon. Which do you think has more moisture? Nylon pellets or nylon pantyhose? Let's find out. Nylon, like other plastics, is used to manufacture products, one of which just happens to share its name. Nylons are made from hair-thin strands of nylon thread. That thread is made by melting nylon pellets and sending the melted substance through an extruder. It's important to test both nylon pellets and nylon thread for moisture content. A specific level of moisture is needed to maintain the strength of the material throughout its life cycle as it changes from pellet to pantyhose. Too little moisture can clog the extruder and hold up the production process, while too much moisture can cause excess runniness, splay, and drool. It's obvious from our test that the nylon pantyhose has a higher moisture content than either the wet or dry nylon pellets. The pantyhose came in at about 2% moisture, 10 times more than the dry nylon pellets. Even though they may be called nylons, not all nylons are made of just nylon. Sometimes cotton and polyester threads are added to help improve elasticity and comfort in the final product. This pair in particular contained polyester, which could be why the moisture content of the pantyhose was higher than the dry nylon pellets. Also, the mesh-like material of the pantyhose can trap moisture within the weave of the fabric, causing the moisture content to be higher. Thank you for joining us on Moisture Matters. We hope you learned something today, or at least enjoyed watching us test the moisture content of nylon and nylon pantyhose. If you did, let us know by liking, favoriting, and subscribing. And remember, in matters of moisture, nothing matters more than moisture matters.